It's already 2020 and the last time I checked, 3 years ago, bestseller na tong chassis na to. It is the H500 from Cooler Master. It is one of the favorite chassis, even the modders used to have this casing in terms of modification. Kasi nga, in terms of pricing, in terms of aesthetics, in terms of structure, this is one of the chassis that is so neutral and at the same time so beautiful. If you are talking about performance, thermals, and pricing, I think H500 is one of the go-to chassis that you may have. Pero, yun nga lang, as of 2020, they revamped and they released a version 2 of this chassis. So, meron tayo ngayon the H500 ARGB, mga kaibigan. At ito po ngayon ang ating nilagyan ng mga components to have a build with an AMD at the same time. AIO from Cooler Master, Gigabyte in terms of components, and of course featuring the T-Force Extreme ARGB 4000MHz. Dahil dito sa video na to, pag-uusapan din natin ang isa sa mga pinaka-common na na-overlook natin sa pag-build. It is turning on the XMP profile. For what reason na bumili ka ng 4000MHz, 3600MHz, kung hindi mo rin naman i-on yung XMP profile, then you will end up having only 2400 or even worse, 2133MHz. And alam naman po natin, mga kaibigan, na pag AMD Ryzen ang iyong component, you should take advantage high frequency RAMs, dahil yan po talaga yung magbibigay ng sobrang malaking boost in terms of performance pagdating sa Ryzen lineup. And of course, with this video, pag-uusapan din natin ang comparison in terms of thermals pagdating dito sa unit na to, with and without AIO, at the same time, RGB thing about ARGB, dahil nga it is an RGB H500 to ARGB, dahil i-feature din natin dito ang H500 old version and of course the new version. Para sa mas marami pang videos, mga kaibigan, feel free to subscribe. Marami pa po tayong i-release sa mga ganito in terms of case reviews, and of course Secret Lab is coming and new gaming chairs will be featured here on our channel. One of the best things that you will really appreciate about H500 is yung kanyang front panel. It comes with a mesh front panel, pero meron tayong option that you can put an acrylic one. So I don't think that you will still install that acrylic. And since it's already 2020, where the trend is about airflow chassis, halos lahat ng mga casings na naglalabasan is bumabalik way back 10 years ago. Na ang usapan pagdating sa casing is kumusta yung airflow, kumusta yung clearance. For the side panel, it's still the same compared to the H500 old version. It is still a tempered glass panel. So same din naman sa old version, mesh din yung kanyang front panel. Pero one thing that I really appreciate in here is the side vents dito sa front panel. Sobrang lucky nung kanyang pagkaka-protrude, yung pagkaka-emboss nung front panel. And you can appreciate in here this beautiful pattern, at the same time this beautiful clearance for more airflow para sa intake. So napakagandang move yan na ginawa ni Cooler Master. For us who are in a tropical country na sobrang init, and we are experiencing a very high ambient temperature, especially kung wala tayong aircon. And going inside, you will see and appreciate the very good clearance. Meron siyang clearance for a 360mm radiator sa harap. Of course, it's also compatible for 140mm fans. And then at sa top, ganun din, 140mm fans, 280mm. Pero we managed to install in here 240mm radiator. And still, napakaganda ng kanyang clearance, even though we are using one of the tallest RAM on the market, the T-Force Extreme ARGB. Still, the clearance is so good. And then, dito naman sa rear side, meron makikita tayo na stock fan, which is included po yan, together with the two 200mm fans na ARGB. And then sa top, meron siyang magnetic dust filter, power button, na merong shape na logo ng Cooler Master, USB ports, audio ports, and of course, the signature of H500 series, yung kanyang handle. So, if bubuhatin mo tong chassis, at least you have the handle na pwede mong hatakin. para at least maiangat mo. So it's a additional feature for comfort, which is still functional. And at the same time, in terms of aesthetics, maganda rin siya kasi nagdadagdag siya ng pagka-aggressive at saka pagka-brusko nung chassis. And then moving on to the power shroud, makikita nyo dito na made of plastic po siya, which is okay lang naman since it comes with this texture. Hindi naman siya glossy, so it's not that much prone in terms of scratch. And ito is kailangan mong tanggalin with one screw in here at the back. So tatanggalin mo yung isang screw para slide out mo siya, and then now you can manage to plug your power supply. Then dito naman sa banda dito is yung HDD cage, which is the traditional setup ng mga classic casing. Ma-access mo siya through this main side panel. Kumbaga, dati-dati kasi kadalasan talaga dito mo siya i-access. Lately lang nung nauso ang mga PSU shroud, nasa kabilang side na ina-access ang mga HDD cage. Which is, I still appreciate because it comes with HDD caddy na merong cover. So kung HDD caddy lang sana yan, medyo mapapailing ako kasi parang medyo nakaka-distract. Pero since meron siyang cover, then I appreciate this move done by Color Master. It's easier, it's more comfortable pagdating sa pagsuswap ng mga hard drives kasi hindi mo na kailangan hawiin yung cable management dun sa kabila just to access the hard drives. Kasi yan po yung isa sa mga pinaka-common na problema natin minsan. Having this kind of option na nilagay ni Color Master dito na you can just access the hard drive at this side, then it's a good move done by Color Master for retaining this kind of feature na meron na dati sa H500. So, teka lang, tanong, meron nga bang nabago? So, aside from the ARGB, of course, for the fans, ang nabago rin is yung kanyang rear view. So, wala na po yung cutouts dito kung saan mo ilalagay yung video card if you want to go for a vertical mount, which is a very not functional feature. Yes, the vertical mount is functional for those guys who will be going for water cooling. For those guys who will avail the casing na worth 15K above, like C700P, na pag sakaling ilagay mo yung video card, still maganda pa rin yung clearance. Pero for this casing, like the other casings below 10K, pag nilagay mo na yung video card dito sa nakaabang na mounting expansion slot covers, automatically you will end up having this not even close to 1cm clearance between the side panel and video card. So ayan po yung nagiging concern. So it's still better if you will use a GPU bracket for your vertical mount setup, which is you can have that from Cooler Master as well. So H500, just get rid that option with this version 2 and encourage yung mga kaibigan na bumili na lang ng GPU bracket, which is really, really right. Kasi baka mamaya mamislead pa yung iba na, uy, may ilagay na pala ng GPU, tapos yun, bibili sila ng GPU. After 6 months, sasabihin nila, ay, sira na yung video card ko, nag-overheat. Dahil nga po, vertical mount mo siya, and nasakal yung kanyang airflow. So, I advise everybody that before you will do that vertical mount setup, you should always check kung maganda ba yung clearance ng casings once na yung video card is meron na. So, you should be aware kung gaano kakapal yung video card. Pero, the best recommendation that I may say, tulad ng sinabi ko at inuulit-ulit-ulit, even with the previous video, inuulit ko ulit to, always buy a GPU bracket kung gusto nyo talagang magkaroon ng magandang vertical mount na configuration. So for the expansion slot covers, standard po siya. And then at the other side, ang isa sa mga ma-access mo na lang dyan is yung lagayan ng SSD, which is minsan pwede kang, nasan dito yung lagayan ng SSD? Pero actually, you will find 8 holes at the other side where you can just plug yung SSD, pero kailangan mong ilagay yung 4 na tornilyo na medyo kakaiba. Nandito muna sa Color Master makikita yung mga tornilyo na yun, which is really a very helpful feature na ginawa ni Color Master. It's easier to install, it's easier to replace your SSD if this is the way that you will install it. And yun nga, sana i-adapt to ng mga ibang brands kasi napakaganda nitong signature or napakaganda nitong feature. Though I just don't know kung patented siya kay Color Master. So, you can just find that kind of feature sa Color Master, which is really a very, very helpful, less hassle installation of SSD. And then, syempre, para mas matest pa natin, para mas magkaroon pa tayo ng idea how cool is this chassis, how good is this chassis in terms of performance, of course, we managed to install 3500X with a pure gaming setup na naglagay tayo ng RX 5700 XT and T-Force 4000 MHz 2x8 16 gig. So yung budget natin is just around the 60k, but we want to show you kung gaano kaganda itong chassis na fully loaded with AIO, with everything inside. And then syempre, for you guys to have an idea how does it look kung meron ng mga fully loaded components inside, we have here the 3500X, RX 5700 XT, Aorus components, and yes, T-Force ARGB Extreme. Nilagay po natin dyan lahat mga kaibigan. Tinest natin yung components outside of the chassis. Tinest natin yung components inside the chassis. We have a very close thermal results in terms of performance. And that is so good for this chassis. And then of course, we added an AIO from Cooler Master. Dito natin nakita mga kaibigan na napakasulit talaga ng chassis na to in terms of airflow, in terms of ventilation inside, that we managed to have those very cool temperature ng processor na it barely reach 50 degrees with an AIO pagdating sa gaming. So dyan natin makikita mga kaibigan that if you are located in a tropical country, having a chassis with this kind of a good airflow, big fans, 200mm, low RPM, 800rpm only, but it's big in size. So kung makikita nyo sa mga malls, may mga malalaking electric fan dyan sa taas, mga event place, bakit ang bagal ng ikot pero ang lamig pa rin sa loob? Kasi nga, it's not about the speed. It's not about the... Ito na yung sigurong magpapatunay na sometimes size matters. And then syempre, let's move on to the part ng Extreme ARGB RAM from T-Force. T-Force released a new RAM again in the market and we have this high frequency option na 4000 MHz. And here we will show you that with the 4000 MHz compared to the XMP profile off na 2400 MHz, ayan po yung mangyayari. Pag hindi nyo po inon ang inyong XMP profile, you will just have almost half of the performance ng ating RAM, 2400 MHz. Versus 4000 MHz. And here we have this kind of benchmark with GTA 5. Makikita nyo that the figures, the numbers won't lie. The 4000 MHz delivers a very big impact in terms of FPS gain. Halos parang bago kang video card. Parang halos magkaiba yung video card on how it looks in terms of the benchmark na pinagko-compare natin ngayon side by side. And you can see in there mga kaibigan how important na dapat sa mga kaibigan natin dyan, kung hindi nyo pa alam, please turn on the XMP profile or know how to turn on the XMP profile. Alam ko po marami sa mga kaibigan natin na aware na of this, pero you will be a shock if a lot of our friends still don't know about this XMP profile thing. Okay, syempre, dadagdag ko na rin yung feature sa AMD driver or sa Radeon settings that you can also turn on the AMD sharpening image for you guys to take advantage also of better quality in terms of experience. So, iba pa rin yung magiging experience mo, mas sharp, lalong-lalo na kung naka-AMD video card kayo. So, makikita nyo naman dyan, very obvious, sa pavement pala makikita nyo na super sharp, hindi siya blurry tulad nung isa na walang image sharpening or hindi naka-turn on yung image sharpening. So, feature that you should take advantage also guys. Marami pang feature na actually isisingit-singit ko sa mga bawat videos na ilalabas ko mga kaibigan, pero we will take it slow, one by one. Like for now, we have two things that we have talked to para kahit paano dahan-dahan lang na maifi-feed ko sa inyo mga kaibigan yung mga bagay-bagay. Okay, so overall in terms of performance, we managed to have a very good result in terms of 1080p gaming and 1440p gaming. So kung ikaw kaibigan is nagbabalak ka na mag-build ng isang unit that is for gaming and it comes with a very good upgrade path, then this is the best choice that you may have. Having a 3500X at a 60k, almost 60k budget, and an RX 5700 XT is already good in terms of leaning towards gaming build. Ngayon, pwede nyo i-suggest sa akin na why not just go for Intel? Alam naman po natin mga kaibigan that Core i5 or i9 series or 9th gen series is about to be phased out in the next few months. 10th gen is coming, and when 10th gen is released, wala pong upgrade path yung 9th gen natin. Automatically, you need to sell that 9th gen i5 9400 and your motherboard for you to have another set of 10th gens. It is better if I will suggest that you should go for the 3500X. Aside from it comes with a better performance in terms of production, it also comes with a better upgrade path in the future. So we have here the 3500X with RX 5700 XT, and yes, as you can see, even with the Battle Royale games, current games like Warzone, we have a very good result in terms of benchmarks. And sa mga kaibigan natin dyan who are looking for the cheapest with a very good upgrade path 1440p gaming setup, this is the best recommendation that I may have for you. Actually, nakita ko rin po yung nilabas ni Hardware Unbox that they released the Sulit, or I think titled cheapest or most affordable bang for the buck 1440p setup. Ayun, it comes with this RTX 2060 video card, and for me, I will be recommending the RX 5700 XT video card since we have the opportunity here in the Philippines to have the 3500X instead of the 3600. And the point in here is, yung 3500X kasi po, mga kaibigan, kaya po medyo yung ibang mga YouTubers international is hindi nila nagagawang i-feature siya kasi wala po sa mga region nila. And here in the Philippines, available po siya. And it's a very good thing that we can have the processor from 3600 to 3500X and just pick a better video card, since the video card will have the better function or will have the bigger role in terms of making this a unit that will be a very good in terms of 1440p gaming experience. So that's it, mga kaibigan. Hopefully you appreciate our benchmark in terms of thermals, in terms of discussion pagdating sa chassis na to. H500 is really one of the chassis that I may recommend sa inyo, mga kaibigan, lalong-lalo na kung naghahanap kayo ng worth 6K plus. This is the chassis that you should have. It comes with a very good airflow. We are in a tropical country. A chassis like this is also a very good in terms of future proof. Napakaganda rin po ang kanyang future proof since yung kanyang design is hindi siya yung kumbaga parang madaling maluma. Imagine na lang, mga kaibigan, kung naluma siya. H500 is 3 years old chassis, and it's still revamped to a new ARGB variant with just the fans added, and still it looks like a very contemporary chassis as of 2020. So it's also expected that by 2023, 2024, 2025, this is still the chassis that you may recommend to your colleagues or to your friends, or you may still consider to use it if you have this H500 version 2. Alright, so that's it, guys. Feel free to subscribe for more videos like this. We will be featuring more chassis, more gaming chairs, more builds in the future. And in the coming days, marami po kayong aabangan dahil medyo sisipagin po tayo. Keep safe, everyone. Nasa gitna tayo ng isang crisis ngayon. And yes, I'm also taking advantage of this time of lockdown na wala akong ibang errands or trabaho to release more videos compared to the previous months. So that's it, guys. Thank you so much. Comment down below. And yes, feel free to subscribe.